following a quick reposition, the Tomcat will return to show center from the left, performing a series of turns called the flat eight. This maneuver will provide you with an all-aspect view of the Tomcat. Take note of the glow coming from the afterburner cams of each engine, indicating that full afterburner is selected. While in full afterburner, the Tomcat is burning over 2,000 pounds or 300 gallons of fuel every minute.
Accelerate away from the deck.
mile. In this turn, the air crew will be slammed into their seats at 7 G's or 7 times the force of gravity. It's the ability to outturn and outgun your opponent that can determine the victor in air combat. Fly to fight. Fight to win. Tomcat will be approaching for the pop-up tuck under brake to landing. This maneuver is utilized to slow the aircraft from 600 miles per hour to a more comfortable 125 and give the crew time to set the landing configuration. As it approaches, watch how the Tomcat rolls right and turns left. Likely event of a boulder, if the hook should skip and miss all four wires, the crew takes off and goes around for another try. Padilla will perform a touch and go. The Tomcat will perform the touch and go, gear extended, and perform the dirty roll on takeoff, demonstrating the tremendous power and superb slow speed handling characteristics of the F-14.
Thank you.
get truck of Lesson Donna Shockley, Kent Shockley, their 35-year-old son, sitting up in the cab of that Peterbilt truck. That's a Corduroy Racing Chassis with three J34 Pratt & Whitney jet engines, the same engine that's in a T2 Buckeye. Look out! Utilizing tactics begun in the Gulf War, and with the addition of the Lantern laser targeting pod. The Tomcat is now the premier precision strike platform in the Navy, capable of carrying a wide array of air-to-ground ordnance, including conventional bombs, rockets and cluster munitions, avionics and flight control upgrades, will make the Tomcat a viable warplane until beyond 2010. Grumman Aerospace built 712 Tomcats, with the first fleet squadrons deploying in 1972. At the time of its retirement, it will have become the longest-serving fighter in the history of our United States Navy. Following shutdown and a quick post-flight inspection, the crew will be happy to answer any questions about today's demonstration, the F-14, or the United States Navy. The radar intercept officer from VF-101, the Grim Reapers, formerly of the Ghost Riders, VF-142, and the top hatters of the F-14 from Cincinnati, Ohio, Lieutenant Jerry Pearl Morick, and the pilot, formerly of the top hatters of the F-14 and the Black Lions of the F-213, from San Antonio, Texas, Lieutenant Marcel Opus Padilla. And we sure hope you enjoyed that. Did you like that? Was that fun or what? We're going to work on this, and we're going to try to do it again tomorrow. You might tell your friends and neighbors and drag them all back here for another day of fun in the what we hope is going to be. The folks are coming by from Wavy, from WAVY TV 10. They are taking pictures. Everybody give them a great big wave right now. Wave to Wavy.
Hey.
Give them a great big, go ahead, we're going to give the Queen's wave. That's this kind of wave. Debbie's doing the Queen's wave. We'll stand here and go like this. We're center point, folks, right here. We're right here. Me and Ray. Here's me and Ray. Take our picture. And it's been a long time before. Man. How about that race a few minutes ago between the Tomcat and the USCA and our...